हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक। वेलकम टू द चैप्टर 3 ऑफ स्प्रिंग बूट वेब सीरीज। एंड इफ यू गाइस रिमेंबर इन द लास्ट वीडियो इन चैप्टर 2 वी हैव इंस्टॉल्ड MySQL सर्वर, राइट? नाउ इन दिस वीडियो वी विल टॉक अबाउट MySQL सर्वर कमांड्स, बिकॉज लाइक एज अ डेवलपर यू मस्ट नो सम बेसिक कमांड्स टू क्रिएट डेटाबेस, टू क्रिएट टेबल्स, टू अल्टर कॉलम्स, एंड यू मस्ट नो how to execute SQL statements like insert, update, or delete and drop and all, right? So we'll quickly focus on some very important commands in this video. And if you guys really want to learn all the commands and all about MySQL servers, then you can just go to google.com and there you can find tons of videos on MySQL server. But as part of this video, I'm just repeating my sentence, as part of this video or the intention of this video is to learn the basic commands that like you would need those commands as part of this Spring Boot web series. Okay, so that being said, let's begin the video. So what I'm gonna do is I'll just go and open my MySQL command line client. So this is how it looks like. This looks like your Windows terminal. Okay, so here if you see, this guy is asking me to enter my password. So this is the password which I created when we installed the MySQL server. You can watch the video here how to install MySQL server, because like, just let me tell you one thing, MySQL installed only a specific component, because in this video I have just covered how to install only MySQL server, not the other components, right? So just watch this video and install MySQL server first. Once you are ready with your MySQL server database, then you can watch this video here. Okay, now I'm gonna enter my password. It says admin. So now you can see I'm connected to server 8.0.919, MySQL community server. Okay, now here, so here is your window and you want to run a command. So for that, what you do is just simply go, let's see what if we have any existing database in the system, whether MySQL comes with some default database or not. So the command is this one, show databases, ES. So here you will see all the existing database. So if you can see, I have one. So these two are built in, MySQL underscore schema, MySQL performances, and UserDB is the one which I created. So let me just go and show you how to create a database. You type the command is create database, and then you enter your database name depending on your need. So most probably it should be as per your application need. For example, if you are working on shopping database, right, then you just create ShoppingDB. So it says there is a problem with the database name. Why? Because you cannot add dash. But if you want, I think you can create, you can have underscore db will work for you. So let me just go and see whether we have the new database. So now here is your database, shopping underscore db. It's created for you guys. Okay. Now say for example, if you are not happy and you just want to drop and you want to recreate, what it is, drop and then database and then give your database name. So my database name is shopping underscore db. Hit enter. Let me just see if I still have or it's gone. Let me just verify. Now you see your database is gone. It's no more exist. It's no more there in the database server. So this is how you can create the database, right? Okay, so I'm just going to create the database here. Okay, let me create new database. So the command is create database. I'll call it app underscore db, my application database name. If you want, you can run the command. So if you use your keyboard down and up arrows, you will get your previously executed commands, right? So this is my command to see whether I have my database ready or not. So you see your application db, app db is available to me, right? Okay, now let's go and see how to create a table. But before that, you see there are a number of databases. So first you have to select a database, like in which database you want to create a table. You cannot simply go and create a table, right? First of all, you need to select a database. So the command to select a database is like use is the command, and then db is the database name. So basically I'm going to use database name application underscore db. For example, I want to use my other database, that is UserDB, right? UserDB. This is how it is. Now I'm working on UserDB, right? So for this video, we'll be working on application db, use is the keyword and space your database name, right? Now For example, let me just see whether I have any tables or not in this particular database. If you see, nothing is there, no tables available at this moment. So let's go and create a table. Now I just want to save the time of you guys. So what I have done is, like, I already have the SQL statements. I simply paste here. Let me just explain. So if you see here, I hope you guys can see my screen. It says create table, table name, application underscore users. Then I have columns first name, varchar type, last name, then username, email, phone number, then timestamp. Let's go and hit. So it says query, okay, zeros affected. So basically we have successfully executed the SQL statement to create the table. Now if you go and run the command show tables, you will see there is one table in this database, app underscore user, right? So this is how you can go. And now if you want to see the columns of this table, so for example you want to see that how many columns are there in this particular table, or the type of this particular, like that, or type of the columns of this table, then the command is describe underscore describe space your table name. What is this? Okay, one second. You are always supposed to end your statement, your SQL statement, with the semicolon. Now if you see here, I can see the all my table layout, table structure. It says field first name, last name, username, email, phone number, timestamp. Here you can see the type, the column types, null, key, default, extra. So this is all, this is how you can work on the tables, right? Because like when you're working on a web application, we need to have database, we need to have some tables, right? So this is how you're going to create tables before, and before you go and start your application, right? So this is the one part. Now if you see, we have something called default, and as of now there is no primary key here in this table. So let's go and create one. Okay, so here let me just go and create a new table called active users TB. I'll call it as table active users, or I'll simply write here TB underscore active users is my table name. Okay, I have ID auto incremented. Let me just copy this one and then I'll explain here for you guys. Just paste this one. Let me hit enter. You have an error. Check my SQL server. Near default. Status is fine. I just want to have this character too. Okay, now you see there was a problem with the syntax, because here if you see, I forgot to specify the size, the length and type of this particular column status. So I put this one here, like a status character of 2, and by default it should be active because my table says all my active users. Now let me see if I can, I just want to see how does it look like, or let me just see the number of tables in this database. So now you can see that we have two tables now in the database. One is application underscore users and another one is TB underscore active users. Now I want to see the columns of new table, that is TB underscore underscore active underscore users. You should always end your SQLs with semicolon. Now here you can see ID, username, first name, last name, status. Now you see, what is primary key? Primary key is your ID. It cannot be null, and it's part of your primary key, auto increment, right? So when you're going to insert the records, this ID will be keep on increasing by one. And if you see the status, by default is gonna be active status, default values. You can alter by using some, what do you call that, update commands. So in the coming video, we'll see, and we'll also run some SQL statements to see. So for example, if I run here, select star from, my table name is TB underscore active underscore, sorry, TB underscore active underscore users. If you see, what is this, select, oh sorry. Now you can see, right, there's a problem with my SQL statement, it's incorrect statement. So I've used S double E. It should be select star from your table name, TB underscore active underscore users. So empty set. So there are no records. Now before I wind up this video, Let me just go and create one more table. I call it create table. I'll call it as a dummy table. And I just want two columns here, like say ID, character 5. And I can have one more parameter name called name, and then 10 semicolon. Let me just go and see the tables, whether I have the tables ready or not. Okay. I again committed a mistake. So to come out of this pointer thing, right, you should use control and then C to cancel. Show table semicolon. Now here I can see I have one more table called dummy. I just want to drop this table. So let's see how to drop a table in case, like when you start working, initially start working on the database side, drop table and then table name. This is how you are going to drop. Gone. Let me just go and run the tables. Now you see the dummy table is no more there. So basically, friends, in this video, we have covered how to create a database, how to create a table, how to drop a database, and how to drop a table. Now, before you go and start working on a table, you're supposed to make use of use keyword, use database, because you first choose your target database and then only you can work on the tables, right? So that's it for this video, guys. In the coming video, we'll talk more about the alteration of the tables, like how to alter a column length, column name, how to rename a table and all, right? That we'll see in the part 2 of MySQL Server commands. Thank you for watching. Bye for now.